Hey guys, how's it going? I'm your host, Jared Bronstein, and welcome to Life's Biggest Questions. This is your first time checking out our channel. Let me be the first to welcome you. Welcome. Make sure to hit that subscribe button and click that bell so you guys never miss a video. Give this video a good old thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and share it with a friend to let them know what happens if you were to lose oxygen for an hour. Of course, if you're returning to our channel, welcome back, thanks for tuning in, and as always, drop us some comments below with other videos you'd like to see on here. As we always do, I'll be replying to some of your comments from a previous video at the end of this one. Today we'll be looking at what would happen if we lost oxygen for an hour. I can tell you right now, it's a bad look for everyone and everything. Humans, buildings, animals, the earth. It would be a bad time all around. Let's figure out why. Well, for starters, obviously we need oxygen to breathe. Most humans can only go so long without it. If you're lucky, maybe you can go a minute. Some even longer. But no one, and I mean absolutely no one, can live without oxygen for an hour. Meaning, inevitably, we'd all die without oxygen for an hour. No surprise there, right guys? Welcome to LBQ. I'm kidding. Not really. But that's not all. Aside from us pretty much choking to death, even though we'd lose consciousness before we died, technically, our ears would also pop. And by pop, I mean explode. It would hurt a lot. You know when you go on an airplane or take an elevator down from the 50th floor, and sometimes your ears feel clogged in a sense? That's because of the change in air pressure. If we lost all oxygen, we would lose approximately 21% of the air pressure instantly, and our ears would not be able to adjust to that very quickly, meaning they'd pretty much explode. Very, very painful. Now, while all of this is going on, our skin would also be burning to a crisp. This is because oxygen actually makes up the ozone, which blocks out some of the UV rays. Think of it this way. On a very sunny day without any sunscreen, you can still get a pretty bad burn. Imagine that times 100. Our ozone absorbs more than 99% of UVC rays, 90% of the UVB rays, and 50% of UVA rays. If we didn't have anything blocking us from those rays, in this case, the ozone, which is made up of oxygen, the sun would absolutely burn us alive. But between the bad sunburn and our ears popping, we'd only be in pain maybe for 30 seconds. Albeit the most excruciating pain, most of us will lose consciousness from the lack of oxygen. That is, if we don't lose consciousness from the pain we're already enduring. Then again, with such a sudden drop in oxygen, our bodies would probably go into shock. All of our cells would die. So our death could also possibly be instantaneous. Isn't this fun, guys? Well, guess what? There's plenty more to cover. All the skies will most likely turn black. Not due to clouds, but because there would be fewer oxygen molecules spread out blue light. So we'd still get burnt alive, even though the sky would most likely be completely black. If that's not scary enough for you, all planes, cars, really anything with an engine would stop working as well. It can't burn fuel, therefore, down they go. Between the cars suddenly stopping, planes falling out of the black sky, us having the inside of our ears burst, and of course being burnt alive, surely that would be the end of it, right? What a joke. No chance, it gets way worse, guys. Way worse. Anything made up of concrete would pretty much turn to dust. As in almost every building, the sidewalks, floors, bridges, you get the idea. Just gone. This is due to the fact that oxygen binds concrete structures together. Speaking of binding, any metals in contact would instantly become welded to each other. Normally, metal is coated in a layer of oxidation, but without oxygen, the metal would immediately weld together. So between the buildings crumbling to dust, planes falling from the sky, the sun, it's quite evident we need oxygen. I think it goes without saying that any living thing, plants, animals, obviously humans, really anything that thrives off of oxygen would die as well. From your dog to the squirrel running across the street, which I guess wouldn't exist anymore because the whole concrete dust thing, all animals would unfortunately have a grim fate. But what about the fish in the ocean? Or any creature living in the ocean? Surely they'd be okay, right? Come on guys, what do you think this is? Life's happiest endings? You're watching Life's Biggest Questions, so you know damn well what happens to all the fish. They die. That's because the oceans would also evaporate. Talk about a rough day. Then again, none of the above would really matter all that much when all is said and done. The Earth's crust and mantle is made up of about 45% oxygen. Without any oxygen, the Earth would pretty much invert in itself. The entire ground would turn to dust, but then there's that molten core that would probably kill us. Kinda like a real life hell. Well, we can't say for sure if we'd go straight down, but there would be catastrophic earthquakes happening from the entire Earth's core shifting in different ways. So all in all, no oxygen for even 10 seconds would destroy our planet. If we lost oxygen for an hour, it would have the exact same effects. Our planet would most likely cease to exist if it lost oxygen for an hour. Although, if you had an electric car, you would still be able to drive because its engine doesn't rely on an internal combustion the way airplanes and cars that burn gas do. He uses electricity instead, which would still work. So I guess Elon Musk is onto something here, guys. Maybe he knows something we don't. In case you guys can't tell, I'm kidding. Having an electric car wouldn't make a difference. You'd still die. Now, if you guys are like me, who had trouble breathing while writing the script, you may have been having some issues breathing while watching this video. So let's just take a moment and breathe. In and out. Three deep breaths. Feel better? If you don't, go outside or something, I don't know. But no need to worry, guys, this isn't happening. Our world has tons of oxygen. We're not going to run out anytime soon. And like I said, if we did, we'd die almost immediately, so it's fine. I mean, it'd suck, but we probably wouldn't be in too much pain. Hopefully not. Only one way to find out. I'm kidding. Anyways, guys, before we wrap up and read some comments, a friendly reminder to subscribe to our channel, click that bell, and give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Maybe share it with a friend so they can endure the uncomfortable feeling of thinking about their breath as well. What a bad feeling. So in the video, what happens if the Russian sleep experiment happened today? Miss Luna said, sounds like a really good horror movie. I feel like there already has been a movie, like a short film on it, but it would be a really good horror movie. The Russian sleep experiment. Be crazy. If you guys haven't seen that video, check it out. Jack did a great job in that video, so watch it. Brown Bear Box Production said, life's biggest answers, there would be a great tiredness. I feel like inevitably your body would just eventually crash, like just make you sleep. Like you physically would just like collapse almost, I don't know. Coop J said, what would happen if Jack Finch wasn't a disembodied floating voice? I don't know, I couldn't imagine what Jack would actually look like. He usually just talks to me over my shoulder while I work. We have good conversation, because he's a disembodied floating voice. And then he just says things in the microphone and we record it. Kind of like a ghost. The ghost of Jack Finch. It's kind of cool. Anyways, guys, on that note, we're going to wrap this one up. I've been your host, Jared Bronstein, who has a full body and face. Apparently not like Jack. He's just a body. Or a floating voice. He's confused me now. Am I just a voice? We're going to wrap this one up, guys. Make sure you like, share, and subscribe to this video. Or I guess this channel. I don't even know what I'm saying anymore. You've been watching LBQ, and we'll see you guys next time.